Let's go to that main story. Reports coming out of the ANC-NEC is that the party has yet to decide on whether disciplinary action will be taken against Derek Hanekom. The former tourism minister admitted, you'll remember, that he met with the economic freedom fighters and discussed the removal of then-president Jacob Zuma. He was publicly condemned by other senior members. So we asked today, are divisions in the ANC widening? Well, to help us answer that question is political analyst Sandile Swana, who joins us via Skype to unpack the tensions within the governing party. Mr. Swana, thank you very much for joining us. We'll talk about Derek Hanekom in a moment. I just want to focus firstly on the president. Reports this weekend suggesting that he has stamped his authority on day one of that meeting on Friday when he tabled his political report there. What's your sense?
I think that stamping the authority is a very dubious statement to make that at this point in time, because since May, only in May, we're now in July, we saw when he had to select the cabinet that in many ways, we could say he was forced to include people that some believe belong to the Zuma faction. And those people have not gone away. They are still there. We've seen some of them pitching up at the Zondo Commission. So to say that Cyril maybe is able now to have the upper hand, it is far too early to say.
But some will say that when we look at things right now and the suggestions that Derek Hanekom may be off the hook, at least for now, there's no disciplinary action that is announced to take place against him, that could possibly give the Ramaphosa faction an upper hand. Is that too much? Are we reading too much into it?
Yeah, first of all, we don't know the official statement, but bear in mind that even the so-called Ace Magashule and others were claimed to have formed a new political party or assisted to form a new political party. That matter has been referred to Kgalema Motlanthe to head up the commission that will investigate. My suspicion is that the same will happen to Derek Hanekom. He might just be put into the same category and given to Kgalema Motlanthe to investigate. I think that the whole idea that there's going to be immediately or in the short term a decisive victory of one faction over the other is actually very problematic. Even the strategy of saying let the courts and other structures like that do their job, it's going to take a long time. Our courts take a very long time. So those people like Museveni, Zwane and others are still going to be in the ANC structures and giving whatever input they want to give for quite some time during the Ramaphosa presidency. So to me, the way to do this thing is to actually focus the organization on the work to be done, the priorities that have been set up, the ANC election manifesto and things of that kind, and allow existing structures to deal with malfeasance.
The other element that was worth noting here, Mr. Swana, is the misgivings by the ANC veterans writing to the Top Six and the NEC about what they say is the role of the Secretary General, Ace Magashule. You remember his statements against Derek Hanekom. And something strange happened this Friday. You will know that at the beginning of any NEC meeting, he will give that impromptu presser to reporters. But that did not happen on Friday when that meeting began. And some saying that this is actually an instruction from the Top Six to say, you will not do this. You will not give the usual press conference because we simply can't trust you anymore.
Yeah, well, that one has been a given for quite some time. And I think Ace Magashule as well is making a mistake. Because he knows that he represents the faction. So even without a sanction or anything like that, a simple request that let a statement be balanced before you issue it, let all sides be heard. I think that is a very fair request from everybody involved in this matter, because otherwise any one of them in the top six can issue a personal statement. So that needs to be curtailed by issuing collective statements and agreed statements.
Mm. Just finally then, Mr. Swana, talk to us about what also is reported to have been the president who managed to calm the waters when it comes to issues of land expropriation and the so-called nationalization of the Reserve Bank. These are the resolutions of the governing party in NASREC. How much longer can the president afford to postpone this, if you like?
The issue of expropriation of land without compensation is neither here nor there, for the simple fact that there is a process, a parliamentary process, and documents are already being circulated, how much progress has been made and where this thing is going. It's not about Ramaphosa, even the ANC. It's a parliamentary process, and it's going on, and there's concrete evidence that it's going on. So these ones who want the president to go up and down shouting slogans like Malema and so on, that is not going to happen. He has never been like that. It's not going to happen. The issue of the nationalization of the Reserve Bank is also neither here nor there, because we already know that if you nationalize the Reserve Bank, it doesn't affect the mandate itself of the Reserve Bank. The issue in South Africa is not necessarily just the nationalization of the Reserve Bank, but the mandate of the Reserve Bank to see what role the Reserve Bank can play, comparable, for instance, to nations like China and earlier on Japan and so on and so forth. Even in the USA, even right now, as we speak in the European Union, the Reserve Bank is taking aggressive steps to restart the economy there, et cetera, et cetera. So those debates are still going to be with us for a long time.
Mr. Swana, thank you very much for your time. That's Sandile Swana. He is a political analyst joining us via Skype from Durban there.